With the mighty Columbia River rolling through eastern Washington, and rainy winters keeping West Side residents indoors for weeks at a time, it's hard to imagine a water shortage in our state. But that's exactly what we are facing in many of our river basins, if we don't manage our water resources responsibly. Our urban and rural communities are competing with agriculture and industry for water supplies, and there still needs to be enough water in streams for fish and wildlife to survive and thrive. Population growth is also increasing demand for water. Washington State is expected to become home to almost another million people in the next 10 years alone. Climate change is affecting mountain snowpack, which provides our water storage for cities and farms. During the summer months, our streams are naturally at their lowest levels. This is a serious problem because that is when our water needs are the highest. The challenges of protecting our water supplies for the benefit of people, farms, and fish have never been greater. Hi, I'm Jim Pacheco, an in-stream flow biologist for the Washington State Department of Ecology. I'd like to tell you about one of ecology's most important tools for managing our precious water resources, in-stream flows. In-stream flows are amounts of water that protect streams for fish and wildlife, recreation, navigation, and scenic beauty. They are specific levels of stream flow for a given river, varying month to month. Once established by an administrative rule by ecology, in-stream flows protect a river from future withdrawals. In-stream flows also protect existing water rights. To determine in-stream flow levels, we usually study fish. A good indication of stream health is whether there's enough water, enough of the time, for fish to grow and thrive. If the fish are doing well, generally, the other in-stream resources are too. Adopting in-stream flow levels in a rule gives legal protection to the animals, plants, and uses, such as boating and swimming, that depend on adequate water in streams. In-stream flows protect water in a stream, much as water rights protect people's water uses. In-stream flows have a legal effective date. This date is important because state water law gives access to water on a first-come, first-served basis. Older water rights, also called senior water rights, get met first when water is limited. In-stream flows have a lower priority than all the water rights established before them, so they don't affect existing uses. But in-stream flows do affect water uses that start after they are adopted. Newer users have to stop using water when the needs of older water rights, which may include in-stream flows, are not met. A water right is not a guarantee of water. It just determines your place in line. And sometimes, there's not enough to go around. An in-stream flow might be higher than the flow levels that are usually in the stream. Since stream flows naturally vary from year to year, and because it takes a fairly wet summer to provide a good amount of fish habitat, in-stream flows are commonly set at the rare, higher flows. Even if those higher flows are only met one season in 10, the benefits to the fish population could last for many years. No one has to put water back in a stream to meet an in-stream flow. If in-stream flows are not being met, it simply lets ecology know that there is little, if any, water available for new uses. If we set an in-stream flow at a level low enough to be met most of the time, all the water above that low level would be given away to new uses. This means that these low flows would never be exceeded, and fish would live in deadly drought-like conditions every summer. We don't think this would satisfy our state's legal standard to protect and preserve fish and other in-stream resources over the long term. In-stream flows also affect well users, such as households, agriculture, and industry. In-stream flows can affect wells because streams are almost always connected to water in the ground, called groundwater. In the summer, most of the water we see in streams is coming from groundwater. Hydrogeologists have confirmed that using water from wells captures groundwater that would otherwise have seeped into streams. While the impact of one private well may not amount to much, the impact of many wells, especially in the summer, reduces already limited water in streams. In-stream flow levels are determined by scientific studies. Specially trained biologists from ecology and the Washington Department of Fish and Wildlife go out to streams and collect and evaluate data. This information is entered into widely used computer programs. The result is a model that shows how much habitat is available for different fish, at different life stages, at different stream flow levels. With this understanding of the fish habitat to stream flow relationship, ecology works with citizens, local governments, and tribes to develop in-stream flow rules. In-stream flows are a valuable tool in the water management toolbox. Here's what in-stream flow rules do. They protect streams from future withdrawals, both surface water and groundwater. They are used by ecology to manage water and to figure out how much there is for new users, and they give the stream legal status, similar to a water right. Here's what in-stream flows do not do. They do not require people to put water in streams. They do not guarantee water will always be in the stream to meet in-stream flow levels. And they do not reduce existing or senior water rights, including small household wells. Establishing in-stream flows helps ensure there is an adequate water supply for people and the environment. We all want Washington to have healthy streams, abundant fish and wildlife, and water to meet people's needs, now and for future generations.